Integer chapter next topic is division of integers. Let us understand the rules. When we divide a negative integer by a positive integer, we divide them as whole numbers and put a minus sign before the quotient. What does the rule say? See, when we divide a negative integer, so when you are dividing negative integer by a positive integer, this is a negative integer divided by a positive integer, we divide them as whole numbers. So divide them as whole numbers as if sign is not there. 6 divided by 2 is 2, 3 are 6. So quotient is 3. We divide them as whole numbers and put a minus sign before the quotient. So understand the first rule. When we divide a negative integer by a positive integer, we first divide them as if we are dividing whole numbers and put a minus sign before the quotient. This is the first rule. Now see the second rule. Second rule is, when we divide a positive integer by a negative integer. So when we divide a positive integer 6 divided by negative integer 2. When we divide a positive integer by a negative integer, we first divide them as whole numbers. Again we are doing the same. We divide them as whole numbers. So 6 is divided by 2, 2 3s are 6, quotient is 3 and remainder is 0. We first divide them as whole numbers and then put a minus sign before the quotient. We divide them as if we are dividing whole numbers and put a minus sign before the quotient. Understand? When we divide a positive integer by a negative integer, we divide them as if we are dividing whole numbers and put a minus sign before the quotient. Now let us understand the third rule. When we divide a negative integer by a negative integer, so whenever you are dividing a negative integer, take for example third example, I will erase this part. Third example is negative 6 divided by negative 2. When we divide a negative integer by a negative integer, we first divide them as whole numbers. Again we have to do the same. 6 divided by 2 is 2, 3s are 6, quotient is 3 and remainder is 0. So we divide as if we are dividing whole numbers. When we divide negative integer by negative integer, we divide first as if we are dividing whole numbers and then put a positive sign. Even if you don't give the sign, it is considered as positive. So this is equal to positive. Please understand, whenever negative integer is divided by a negative integer, we get a positive answer. This can be understood in other way also. Minus 6 into 2 is equal to 12. Understand this. We know division is opposite of multiplication. So if you divide, minus 12. When you divide minus 12 by 2, you will get minus 6. And the other way is also there. When you divide minus 12 by minus 6, you will get a positive 6. Because division is opposite of multiplication. So this can be understood in this way. Or if you take another example, 6 into negative 2 is also equal to minus 12. This is what we have studied in multiplication. And division is opposite of multiplication. It means when negative 12 is divided by 6, we will get negative 2. And when negative 12 is divided by negative 2, we will get a positive 6. Understand this? Since we know that division is opposite of multiplication. Dear friends, next point is the properties of division of integers. First property is, division of integer is not commutative. That it means if you divide negative 8 by 2, we will get negative 4. And when you divide 2 by negative 8, we will get negative 0.25. So it means this answer is different and this answer is different. It means we can say that division of integer is not commutative. You cannot change the sequence of division. That is what it means. Any integer divided by 1 gives the same integer. This is the second property. If you divide negative 6 by 1, we will get negative 6. If you divide 7 by 1, we will get 7. It means any integer divided by 1 gives the same integer. Third property is, for any integer a, if a is any integer, a divided by 0 If you divide any integer by 0, it cannot be defined. It is not defined. It is meaningless. We get a meaningless value if any integer is divided by 0. This is the third property. Let us go to the fourth property. Division of integer is not associative. It means we have already studied, if you change the sequence of division, we will not get the same answer. It means division of integer is not associative. You cannot change the sequence while doing division. Fifth property is, when we divide any integer by negative 1, if you divide any integer by negative 1, if you divide 6 by negative 1, you will get negative 6. We get its additive inverse. You can understand, 6 and negative 6 are additive inverse. If you divide minus 7 by negative 1, we will get a positive 7. It means we get an additive inverse if you divide any integer by negative 1. Last property is, division of integer is not closed under division. Means if you divide 8 by 2, we will get an integer. Please understand, integer divided by integer is an integer. It means it is closed under division. But this will not be always true. If you divide 8 by 3, we will not get integer, not integer. It means division of integer is not closed under division.